All right, you guys ready to get this review started?
No.
Cody?
No. No.
Why? What's...
Because.
Why not?
You're an idiot.
Yeah.
Who doesn't like any DC movies?
You're so lame.
You suck! You know what? Maybe we should kick your fucking ass.
What are you wearing?
Whoa.
A V-neck?
Yeah.
My
yeah.
God, you guys are...
Nice V-neck.
Physically yeah. intimidating.
Who yeah. got that for you? Your mom? Shazam!
Whoa! You got bullet immunity?
Do you yeah. have boobs?
Yeah, I got both of those. What I don't have is dick immunity.
Come on, boys.
Show me a good time! Cody here from Movie Losers back with another review. This time, an early review of Shazam! Comic book, got nothing there. The later action. Thank you, yeah. Joe.
So this is the kind of story of Billy Batson, a foster kid who seeks kind of validation and finding who his parents are, but along the way he kind of gets introduced to this wizard who gives him abilities based off him being pure at heart, and when he
You're
says the word
Billy.
That was supposed to be Hagrid. Okay.
Yeah.
And so when he says Shazam, he gets super magical powers that allow him to have essentially all the abilities of Superman except without like laser vision and like ice breath.
I can't remember the last comic book story we had where we got like the villain's perspective. At like a different age.
Maybe Loki?
Yeah, Loki and Thor. Yeah. Good example. And I love that about the first Thor movie.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't take long to set up. It gets you in invested into the bad guy, which always works for like the coming conflict.
Yeah, it definitely was a strong suit, kind of setting up the villain, kind of showing his motivations on what kind of drives him, right?
Mm-hmm.
That was a brilliant part by David F. Sandberg, the director. He did a fantastic job with kind of the flow of the movie like that.
He's a really, really good director because from a horror standpoint, he directed Annabelle 2 Creation, which we saw. I remember really, really liking that movie.
Yeah.
For like a sequel to a like spinoff
right.
of a popular series. Really good stuff. I felt that horror element a few times, actually, with some of the stuff the bad guy did in this movie. This felt like a Marvel movie in a lot of ways, where you had a good balance of emotional core and then a lot of laughs. Probably, I'd say this was, as far as like origin stories go, up there with the best of what Marvel has to offer.
Yeah, definitely I would agree.
Oh, yeah.
Joe, jump in with your thoughts.
I love the story. Just, yeah, like how they set it all up, like just the backstory of like Shazam and yeah, how he got the powers.
Did a good job, yeah, like you said, setting up that character even from a small age, giving us good background to why Billy Batson is the way he is. Sorry,
sure.
Go ahead.
No, yeah, the action was great in it. Hilarious, like the whole movie. Like all
it was
the comedy.
A knee slapper.
Yeah, hit.
You're gonna be laughing at this movie a lot.
Yeah.
Or just that really that dynamic between like brothers and sisters. The family, the school dynamic.
Even leading into like that fish out of water, a kid who's kind of in an adult body now.
Right. There's a lot of things happening at once where you have a lot to mine comedically.
Yes.
I like the magic aspect.
Yeah, they didn't, again, delve too much into the specifics of what the magic exactly is. So like I left the movie intrigued by this universe, like wanting to know more about the magic, how it plays a role into the larger universe, kind of like Doctor Strange.
Me and Joe kind of talked about after the movie that there's a little bit of like Deadpool in this, that it made fun of the kind of the superhero genre.
Yeah.
In respects that it's already been put out into a TV spot, but there's this aspect where they're kind of him and Dr. Savannah are speaking, but they can't hear each other because they're so far away.
Right.
It's just kind of like it felt like a Deadpool movie when they made that joke. But one of the other things that really stood out to me was the CGI in this movie for a movie that's budgeted just around maybe even a little bit less than $90 million, which is very low on the DC EU scale. The CGI worked on it for numerous characters, including Shazam himself, and I thought the suit looked fantastic as well.
The cinematography it definitely stood out more than the other DC films for me as well. Now, Aquaman was pretty rich in color, but
yeah.
This was more land-based, and I like that. It taking place at Christmas as well. Like, I don't know, this always seemed... And in Philadelphia, there's a lot going on where it made it feel really refreshing.
Right.
And different. When you got, like, a comedy and a lot of wackiness going on, you kind of want a bright, feel-good color palette. And that's
Zachary Levi. Provided. Awesome.
Yeah, I mean, if you've seen Chuck, it's one of my favorite series ever. He's just, I think he was a great cast. Really, top to bottom, the cast worked for me. The Foster family, the parents.
Yeah, I was just going to bring that up. The Foster family really stood out to me because this movie, unlike a lot of DCEU films, I'm speaking to Joe also about this, this had a theme and it stayed throughout the whole movie. It hits you hard with family and what does family mean to you and how caring for people and trusting for people can be a good thing and rewarding. And I thought the Foster family was fantastic. There's actors and actresses in there who come from shows like This Is Us and Fresh Off the Boat, which are two fantastic shows. So yeah, the Foster family and that dynamic of just hitting you with the themes of the movie really worked.
I'm fresh off a revelation that you guys talk to each other without me. I mean, I thought I was part of the family. You guys are, me and Joe spoke about this already.
Yeah.
What do we have to look forward to in the review then? You guys are sharing all your secrets.
Yeah.
I think I know what you're going to score it. Joe, why don't you go ahead and score it.
All right.
Joe shocks us with a 4.9.
Shocks. Nice.
Shock it.
Nice little Shazam.
Yeah, I think this is...
I feel the same way as Joe. It's definitely my favorite DCEU movie at the very least. It's a fun, like I said, fun, smile-inducing time. I never was bored. I just enjoyed the whole spectacle of it all. It just thoroughly entertained, so this is a 5 out of 5. Go support this movie for a movie that's made so cheaply, and we want DC movies to be like this. Go support this before Endgame comes out and takes all its money.
Stay for a couple post-credit scenes as well. I'm going to give it a 5 also. Maybe my favorite movie of the year so far.
So far.
I honestly think it's one of the better superhero movies, even up there with the MCU.
Definitely a lot of rewatchability with this movie.
Yeah,
strong.
You can go in not knowing, because I didn't know anything about Shazam. You can go in not knowing anything about superheroes, the DCU, really anything, and get some enjoyment out of this film. It's a family film, so take your kids, go see Shazam.
So long. Dun, 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 dun.